Hi, I'm Susan Rutledge, and in this video, I'm going to show you two really good ways to add thick strokes to your text in Adobe Illustrator. Of course, one is going to be my favorite, but you're going to want to know both ways. Now, typically what we do is select an object and come over to the Properties panel, and in the Appearance area, we click to increase the size of the stroke here. And when you're only using a 4 or 5 point stroke on your text, most of the time, that's going to work okay. But if the stroke gets much heavier than that, it makes the font difficult to read. The reason is, by default, Illustrator centers the stroke on the outside edge of your text. So what I end up with on a 5 point stroke is 2.5 points are on the outside of that fill color, and 2.5 points are covering up that outer edge of the fill color. But as the stroke gets thicker, it covers up more and more of the face of the font, making it difficult to read your text. This is probably the worst way to add thick stroke to your font. So I'll move to another document and show you how I made these two samples. I've already got the word Susan selected, and I'm going to convert my font to an outline. Now, because I have text selected on the artboard, I can come to the Properties panel, and down at the bottom of the panel, I have quick actions, and one of them is Create Outlines, so all I have to do is click here. Now, you can see these anchors all around the outside edge of my text, although now it's not really text anymore, it's objects, which I'm going to be able to add my stroke to. I'll go to the Properties panel, and in the Appearance area, I'm going to click on this pull-down menu, and I can choose 20 points right here, and I'll click on the artboard to deselect that. And it doesn't look like our sample yet, but I'll select this again, come back over to the Properties panel, and in the Appearance area, I'll click on the word stroke, and I'm actually able to change the default setting right here. Align stroke to center is selected. This is under Align stroke, and I can come over to this third icon, which is Align stroke to outside, and when I click here, look what happened. I have all of the stroke on the outside of the face of the font. It looks great, and I'm able to read the font. Just know that once you convert your text to an object, you can't go back and change the letters without starting all the way over. So that's the drawback with this method. Now let me move over here to the Layers panel and unhide this second group. And what I'll do here is achieve pretty much the same appearance, but this method is going to allow me to change letters even after I've added that thick stroke. So let me select the object. I'll go back to the Properties panel, and the first thing I have to do is remove the attributes. Now all I have on here is a fill color, so I'll come to the Appearance panel, click on the color fill icon, and select none. I can't see the text anymore, but I know it's there, and I know it's still selected because that selection line is still visible. So now I'll go back to the Properties panel, and in the Appearance area, I'm going to click on this ellipsis, and that opens the Appearance panel where I'm going to actually add the attributes back in. I'll go to the bottom bar of the Appearance panel to click on the Add New Stroke icon, and when I click there, Illustrator adds a 1 point black stroke. The first thing I'll do is click on the Color Fill icon and open the little twirl down menu here and add the blue back in. And I wanted a 20-point stroke, so I'll click here and change the 1 to a 20 and press the return key. And once again, it's hard to read because half of that stroke is on top of the fill color. But the great thing about the Appearance panel is I'm able to manipulate these different layers. What that means is I can grab hold of the stroke layer and I can drag it down underneath the fill layer. What's going to happen is the stroke layer is now going to be underneath the fill color in the Appearance panel, which means it's going to be behind the fill color on the artboard. And that's definitely easier to read, but if both of these have a 20-point stroke, why did they look so different? The reason is because we converted the text to an outline, we were able to change the alignment of the stroke and it's aligned to the outside of the fill color. But this sample is still text, so I'm not able to change the alignment of the stroke like I did on the one above it. So here the stroke is still centered on the outside of the font, but because the fill color has now been moved to the front, you don't see the part of the stroke that's actually hidden by the fill color. So to get the appearance of a 20-point stroke, when I'm using this method, I've actually got to double the 20 and change it to 40 so that I have 20 on the inside and 20 on the outside. So with my text selected, I'll come over here and change this to 40 and press the return key, and then I can close out the appearance panel. And now it looks like I have the same size stroke on both of these samples, but I really like the look of this second one the very best. And the great thing about this method is I'm able to continue to edit the letters. So all I have to do is double click on that Susan and I can type whatever word I want in here, and I can continue to change that all day long. So now you know two great ways to add a thick stroke to your text and still be able to read the font, and in one of the cases, you can even edit the words. Well, I hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you're intrigued by the appearance panel, I'm going to leave a link to a tutorial that goes into depth about all of the things that you can actually do with this panel, and it's really worth the watch. So go check that out next and subscribe to my channel so that you don't miss any of my future tutorials, and I'll look forward to seeing you again next time. Thank you so much for watching. Bye now.